Ascent Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents Power Phone Scripts, 500 word-for-word questions, phrases, and conversations to open and close more sales, by Mike Brooks, narrated by Walter Dixon. Foreword. Let me be brutally honest. The telephone is, has always been, and will continue to be your most powerful sales tool. Not email, not social media, the phone. The brutal and undeniable truth is that inside sales reps who fail to master the phone fail. So it's time to stop looking at the phone like it's your enemy and see it for what it really is, a money-making machine. The telephone is more effective than email and social media because when you are actually speaking to another human being, there is a higher probability that you'll set appointments, gather qualifying information, and close deals. Yet many salespeople find it awkward to use the phone because they don't know what to say or how to say it. Wing it on every call and say stupid, embarrassing things that generate resistance and rejection. Don't have easy-to-execute telephone scripts that allow them to focus on their prospect rather than what to say. Don't have effective strategies for dealing with reflex responses, brush-offs, and objections. What I find across the board, though, is that most salespeople don't know how to use the phone for sales because they've never been taught. This problem is exacerbated by the fact that at most companies, there is deficient to non-existent telephone training. When companies do provide training, it is usually made up of complex, contrived methods developed by people who've never even successfully used the phone for sales. This approach never works in the real world with real prospects. Sadly, most salespeople are making egregious mistakes on the phone. Through their words and approach, they turn prospects off, get shut down, and create resistance where it didn't exist. In inside sales, you have mere seconds to get your prospect's attention. When you have a prospect on the phone, message matters. What you say and how you say it is often the difference between winning or losing the deal. This is where Mike Brooks comes in. Mike isn't a theorist. He's a trench warrior. He's walked in your shoes, made the same mistakes, lived through the same pain, and dealt with rejection. He's also been phenomenally successful. Mike's formula for inside sales excellence was developed through trial and error, working with real prospects in real time in the real world. It was honed in the trenches, and it works. In this book, Power Phone Scripts, 500 word-for-word questions, phrases, and conversations to open and close more sales, Mike teaches you exactly what to say, when to say it, and how to say it. You'll learn the keys to getting past resistance, dealing with objections, and closing the deal. When you follow Mike's formula, you are guaranteed to improve your performance, boost your income, and attain the success you desire. Jeb Blunt, author of the number one bestseller, Fanatical Prospecting, and CEO of SalesGravy.com. Introduction. Dear fellow sales professional, I want this book to be the most important book in your sales career. Actually, I want you to look back at this and someday say that this was the most important book you've ever listened to in your life. I know that is a strong statement, but let me tell you why. Years ago, I was introduced to a sales philosophy and given a set of tools and techniques that changed all my sales results and literally changed my life. I went from a struggling salesperson who hated his job, hated prospecting for business, and hated rejection, to a success. I went from driving a beat-up Nissan hatchback to driving a new Mercedes-Benz. I went from struggling to pay my credit cards each month to buying my first home and furnishing it just the way I wanted it. I went from dreading waking up every morning to waking up with an enthusiasm and confidence I had never known was possible. And it was all from learning and practicing the habits and techniques I am going to teach you in this book today. Please don't think I'm bragging, because I am not. Instead, I like what Anthony Robbins said once. I am not telling you these things to impress you, but rather to impress upon you. What I'm trying to impress upon you today is that if I, a failing and resentful sales rep who thought that life should have dealt him a better card, I was too good to be cold calling as an inside sales rep, I should be doing something more interesting and prestigious with my college degree, could turn my attitude, my results, and my life completely around to having the kind of freedom and success I never thought possible. That if I could do all that using the skills, philosophy, and scripts contained in this book, you can do it too. In fact, I guarantee that if you will just follow the advice you will hear in this book, you too can completely change your sales results. No matter how poorly or how well you are doing now, you can immediately begin doing better. You can begin prospecting with confidence and even get to a place where it becomes fun. Imagine that. By using the scripts and techniques in this book, you can also begin closing more sales and handling objections and stalls that may frustrate you now with ease. And as you learn these powerful and proven techniques, you will not only grow more confident, but you will begin to stand out in your company and in your industry. Soon, you will find yourself in the top elite of producers, the top 20%, as I like to call them. As you begin to change your sales results, your life will change as well. Not only will you begin elevating your lifestyle, but your future will begin to change also. You will begin thinking about things you may not be considering now, like perhaps moving into management or becoming a director of sales or VP of sales. Some of you will begin thinking of opening your own company and using the strategies you will learn here to build a highly successful inside sales team of your own. As you become more successful using these techniques, your world will open up for you, and the sky will become the limit. As you do all of this, you will be changing your family's lives as well. Suddenly, you will be able to afford a better house, better cars, and all the stuff you may wish you had now. Your kids will be able to go to better schools because you will have the resources to afford them. You and your spouse will begin vacationing in the spots and staying in the hotels you always dreamed of staying in, if that's important to you. You will begin saving more money for retirement and putting money into other savings and investments. You will begin living with a sense of security that you may only dream of now, because you will no longer have financial insecurity. You will be able to sleep better at night because you will finally possess the key to selling well. All these things, and more, are available to you once you make a commitment to learning and using the strategies, scripts, and techniques you'll find in this book. Again, I know this to be true because it happened for me. Not only that, but since I figured out the secret to selling easily and with less rejection, I have also taught it to hundreds of companies and thousands of sales reps. Have they all had the results I'm promising you here? Sadly, no. Unfortunately, many sales reps were too lazy to put in the relatively brief amount of time necessary, about 90 days of committed effort, to change the way they were doing things. Instead, they continued to ad-lib their way through their sales calls and simply relied on their old habits. As a result, as they say, if nothing changes, nothing changes. And nothing did for them. However, there have been hundreds of sales professionals who were ready for a better life and were willing to make the commitment, put in the effort, and follow the advice detailed in this book. They, without fail, have achieved a higher level of success, and the ease and comfort that come from mastering these proven sales strategies and techniques. And yes, many of them have gone on to be in the top 20% and even the top 1% of the sales professionals in their respective industries. And you can, too. I developed a mantra when I was learning these techniques all those years ago. A mantra I used to say to myself to keep me practicing and to keep me committed to changing my results. I invite you to adopt it as well. As I sat at my desk in the sea of sales reps, I would look around at the top 3 producers at my company, out of 25 sales reps, many struggling like me, and I thought about the results they consistently produced. They were always on top of the revenue production each month, and they were the ones who drove the nice cars, wore the nice suits, and won all the bonuses. I remember thinking that they had the same amount of hours in a day as I did. They had access to the same scripts and leads. They were selling the same product I was. That was when I developed this mantra. If they can do it, I can do it. Better. I was convinced that if they could do it, heck, they were just as human as I was, then I could do it better. I burned with a desire to change my life. I was sick and tired of struggling, and I knew that if they could achieve the results I wanted, then I could and would dedicate myself to learning better techniques and critiquing myself and my approach daily through listening to my recordings. And I would invest the time, money, and energy needed to become a top producer. I did. By relentlessly studying, learning, and applying the strategies, especially the 10 characteristics of top sales producers you will hear in this book, and by memorizing, drilling, rehearsing, and adapting the word-for-word scripts you will find here, within 90 days, I became one of the top 3 producers in my company. I still remember the incredible feeling I had when I went up before all 25 reps to accept my award for being a top producer. I still remember my commitment to myself as I walked back to my chair. "And you just wait until next month," I said under my breath as I took my seat. 9 months later, by continuing to practice and improve, I was the top producer out of 5 branch offices in Southern California. That next year, the company elevated me to the sales manager of the other 25 sales reps in our office. Within 1 year, I had doubled our office's production by carefully teaching and coaching adherence to the proven principles you'll hear in this book. Most sales reps I worked with immediately increased their sales, and many even moved into the top 20%. Without fail, everyone I have worked with over the years sees improvement in direct proportion to their commitment level and their adherence to the principles and scripts in this book. Why you need phone scripts. As far as phone scripts go, let's address the raging debate about whether inside sales reps should use scripts or not. Everyone has an opinion on this, and while some may be on the fence about it, most people are either very against using a scripted approach, while others advocate using scripts and spend a lot of time and effort creating them for their teams. Those who don't believe in using them cite many reasons, including: using scripts makes you sound like a telemarketer. Following a script is too confining. You have to be able to go with the flow of a conversation. You can't consult with your prospect if you're following a script. Scripts all sound so salesy that it turns prospects off. People can always tell that you're reading something, so you sound unprofessional. You can't script out everything. Sometimes you just need to be able to ad-lib a little. Scripts were okay in the beginning or as a guide, but now that you're a pro, you don't need them. And so on. I bet you can think of a few reasons yourself why you'd never be caught dead following a script. And then there are those who believe that you absolutely must follow a script. Having written several books on phone scripts, you can imagine I subscribe to this group. Some of the reasons I believe you should follow a script are: following a script actually makes you sound more professional. Using a carefully constructed script allows you to follow best practice sales techniques that have been proven to work over time. Following a script ensures that you ask all the right qualifying questions. Scripts make your job easier because you know where you've been and where you're going. Scripts allow you to truly listen to what your prospect is really saying. Having a script to follow gives you confidence and control over the sales process. Following a scripted sales approach allows you to practice perfection on every call. Each of these reasons for following a scripted sales approach powerfully affects each stage of your sales process, and any one of them can make or break a sale. The real argument I present to those who insist on not using scripts is this: whether you know it or not, you already are following a script. Think about it. If I were to record all your calls for a week and then transcribe them and hand that transcription back to you, isn't it true that what I would be giving you was your own script? Isn't it true that you are saying the same things over and over again each time you get a question, objection, or blow-off? Sure you are. You see, right now everyone is already using a script of some kind, but the problem with most of them is that they were developed in the heat of the sale, on the fly, while they were taking incoming from a prospect or client. Most of the responses sales rep use were thought up on the spot and in response to, and often in defense to, some type of difficult sales situation. Just think about how you or your sales team habitually respond to blow-offs like, "What is this call in regard to?" or "We wouldn't be interested," or "Just email me something." Chances are you are using the same old ineffective responses that just cause you frustration and phone reluctance. One of the biggest benefits to using professionally prepared scripts, however, is that you can design the most effective response in advance and then deliver your lines like a professional. I often like to cite Marlon Perkins from the old TV show Mutual of Omaha's Wild Kingdom when making this point. As some of you may remember, his associate Jim was always out in the field wrestling with the alligators while Marlon was reporting from the safety and comfort of the Land Rover. I always remember Marlon taking a sip of iced tea and thinking, "When I grow up, I'm going to be Marlon, not Jim." In sales, it's the same thing. If you are not following a prepared and effective approach, then each time your prospect answers, you are suddenly like Jim, wrestling with the alligators. If you take the time, however, in the safety and comfort of the conference room to craft out the best responses, statements, and questions to the selling situations you run into day after day, then you can calmly and coolly deal with all those situations successfully, and even take a sip of iced tea in between responses. Here is one of the most important things to remember about sales. 80% of the brush-offs, the objections, and the selling situations you get day in and day out are exactly the same. There is very little new in sales. 3,000 years ago in the open markets in Egypt, when a seller told a buyer the price of something, the buyer probably said, "The price is too high." Sound familiar? 80% of the selling situations you face today are the same ones you faced yesterday, last month, and they are the same ones you will get next week and next summer. I cannot stress enough how important this concept is in sales. It gives you, the sales professional, a huge advantage if you take the time to capitalize on it. Unfortunately, the majority of sales reps and companies never leverage this fact. But the top 20% of sales producers do take advantage of this by taking the time to script out proven and effective responses to these objections so they are prepared in advance to succeed. Then, when they get the same old objections or stalls, they know exactly how to handle them. They understand the importance of taking the time to drill, practice, and rehearse effective responses so they can deliver their scripts in a natural and professional tone and at an optimal pace. That is why top producers sound so smooth and professional, and why they make sales seem easy. Because they have taken the time to internalize their best practice scripts, top performers deliver their responses naturally, and they automatically know exactly what to say and when to say it. And just a word about practice. Did you notice I didn't say they read their scripts? Every professional, whether an actor, musician, dancer, or athlete, spends hours and hours learning their craft and practicing their techniques so that when it's time to perform, they do it automatically. All those concerts you see performed by large orchestras and dance routines that seem easy and effortless are all the results of hundreds of hours of careful practice. Don Shula, the Super Bowl-winning coach of the Miami Dolphins, talks about how his players practice every day until their assignments and techniques become automatic. He said, "Overlearning means that the players are so prepared for a game that they have the skill and confidence needed to make the big play." It is the same with any sales professional. If you need to think about how to respond to a question, a blow-off, an objection, or a stall, then it's already too late. If you have scripted out the best approach or response and memorized it, however, Then you will have the skill and confidence to handle those situations like a top producer. This is what empowers you to be successful, and it is what separates you from the other 80% who are struggling and making things up as they go along. So, should you learn and use best practice, real-world responses that give you the greatest chance to succeed in the selling situations you get into day after day? Or should you continue to make things up as you go along, hoping that what you say will occasionally work? The answer to that question will determine whether or not you choose to learn and use scripts, and how successful or unsuccessful you will be in your career. Speaking of scripts, if you have not yet read, practiced, and perfected the core inside sales scripts in my original best-selling book, The Ultimate Book of Phone Scripts, you will benefit even more from those essential scripts. In The Ultimate Book of Phone Scripts, you will find over 200 scripts that give you and your sales team proven and effective ways to easily deal with gatekeepers, get through to more decision makers, overcome objections, and close more sales. The Ultimate Book of Phone Scripts lays the groundwork for selling over the phone and provides the fundamental scripts you need to be successful. Combined with the advanced and additional scripts and strategies you will find here in Power Phone Scripts, you and your sales team will have all the scripts and phone techniques you will ever need to completely turn your sales results around and transform your career, your life, and your company. Get The Ultimate Book of Phone Scripts here. mrinsidesales.com/ultimatescripts.htm. One last word about investing in yourself, your company, and your success. If you are a business owner or sales manager and you want the quickest lift from an investment in your sales team, then do this. Buy each member of your sales team a copy of both Ultimate books and task them with studying, adapting, and incorporating these proven scripts into their sales presentations. Have your sales manager conduct sales meetings to teach these proven scripts and concepts, and watch your sales and revenues begin to take off. This is the most important thing you can do to improve the sales results in your company, because the number one reason the majority of all sales teams struggle is that not many managers are experienced or prepared enough to give these sales reps, the ones in the trenches, the word-for-word scripts and tools they need to succeed. Very few companies are effectively or consistently teaching sales reps what to say and do when they are faced with an objection or challenging sales situation. If you doubt this, then hold a sales meeting and go around the room asking each rep how they handle the standard sales stall of, "I need to ask my partner." I will bet you right now that each rep will ad-lib a different and mostly ineffective answer. This is why your sales team is struggling. The only way to fix that, and so fix your sales results, is to finally give them the exact scripts they need to deal effectively with this and the other selling objections and situations they run into day after day. If you don't do this, then your team will continue to struggle and produce inconsistent results. It's as simple as that. If you do address this glaring need, then your team will immediately begin producing more sales, and you will finally have a way to scale a successful inside sales team and company. If you are a sales professional working at a company, and you're struggling with the idea of investing another $39.95 in a book of phone scripts, ask yourself how much money you paid for all those college textbooks that you sold back to the student store for a quarter of their value. You know, the ones you can't remember anything about right now. Then, compare all those hundreds of dollars you spent, and are still probably paying for through your outstanding student loans, to the under $100 total investment in these two books of Ultimate Phone Scripts and Power Phone Scripts that will make your every phone call better, and which will dramatically improve your life for years to come. It's a no-brainer when you look at it this way. If you put just 90 days into studying and applying the proven techniques and scripts you will find in these two books, you will transform your life. So go ahead. Make the investment in yourself and start changing your future today. How to get the most from this book. This book is broken down into three parts. Part 1, laying the groundwork for success. Part 2, Prospecting Techniques and Scripts. And Part 3, Closing Techniques and Scripts. I suggest you start with Part 1 and the 10 Characteristics of Top Sales Producers to see how many of these you are practicing now and how many you can begin incorporating into your sales life. Each of these core characteristics are practiced by top sales producers across all industries, and even incorporating just one a week can cause a huge shift in your perspective and in your sales results. One of my go-to techniques, for example, is recording and critiquing yourself every day for 90 days. You've probably heard of this suggestion of recording yourself, and your company may regularly record your calls now. But how often do you take it upon yourself to review your own calls? Just this one technique will have a dramatic and instant impact on how you sell. And I personally doubled my income in 90 days by applying this technique in my own career. Every other characteristic will also add to your success. So study and apply each characteristic, starting today. Next, in Part 2, Prospecting Techniques and Scripts, you will find current and proven scripts to help you cold call prospects and qualify better prospects. You'll find many current and proven rebuttals to the blow-offs you may be encountering now. Things like, I'm not interested, and I'm too busy, and so on. You'll also find ways to qualify in crucial core areas like budget, interest, and competition. Remember that you can't close an unqualified lead. So learning how to carefully qualify a prospect without interrogating them will immediately take your sales skills and closing results to another level. As with all these scripts, make sure to invest the time to adapt them to your product, service, and personality. Make them your own, and then commit to memorizing them and using them until they become automatic for you. This is how you will develop the habits of a top 20% producer. In Part 3, Closing Techniques and Scripts, you will finally learn some advanced skills to help you handle a variety of situations that may frustrate you today. Among the techniques you will learn is how to use tie-downs to build yes momentum. This is important because in today's sale, the game isn't about pitching and pitching and then ending with a grand close or prayer that someone buys. The game is instead about presenting your product or services gradually and getting buy-in from your prospect so you know how the sale is going. As you successfully get that buy-in, asking for the sale becomes a natural part of the overall sales process. By the time you do, you should have a good idea of what the result will be and how to handle it. There are also many word-for-word scripts to help you deal with the objections and stalls you may be struggling with now. You will find proven ways to handle things like, I want to think about it, and the price is too high, and we're happy with who we're using now. Once again, your task here is to carefully study these word-for-word scripts, adapt them to your product, service, and personality, and then practice, drill, and rehearse them until they become your new and improved way of automatically reacting and presenting. If you do this, you will begin closing more sales with less rejection. You will also hear about a way to stand out from your competition and position yourself to be the go-to vendor or solution just when your prospect is in the market. It is called send-out cards. sendoutcards.com/MR inside sales. This completely automated service allows you to send customized greeting cards and even gifts to prospects and customers with the click of a button. The real power, however, is your ability to set up an automatic drip campaign that will send any prospect in your pipeline cards at any interval you choose. This system has made me hundreds of thousands of dollars in business that seems to have appeared out of thin air. In reality, people are just reaching out to me when they finally need help, motivated to do so by monthly cards they receive. In this way, I'm able to stay top of mind, and they remember to reach out to me when they suddenly decide to do something about their inside sales training needs. Using the link mentioned here, you'll learn more about this valuable service, and even can try it out by sending a free card to yourself. I encourage you to do this today. Finally, A last note to you, my fellow sales producer. Remember, you can become a top producer if you are willing to put in the time to learn and then practice the techniques you will find in this book. I want to encourage you with all of my heart. I guarantee that you and your family will have an infinitely better life if you just commit yourself to the strategies, scripts, and techniques you'll hear in this book. Look around at the top producers sitting next to you or in your industry and say to yourself, if they can do it, I can do it better. And you can. Part 1. Laying the Groundwork for Success. Chapter 1. What It Takes to Be a Top Producer. 10 Characteristics of Top Sales Producers. If you are listening to this book right now, then I know you want to perform better in your sales career. If you are a business owner, then I know you want to help your sales teams accomplish more. It shows that you are willing to take the time to search out strategies and learn the word-for-word scripts that will give you an edge over your competition. That's a good thing. But are you ready to really commit to doing the things that will catapult you into that rarefied stratum of top sales producers? You know the top producers I'm talking about. They are the ones who are always at or near the top of the sales production list every month, who always win the sales contests, and who always seem to be in a good mood. They are positive and confident, and they have that feeling that no matter what happens to the leads or the economy or the company, they will find a way to succeed. Years ago, I heard a sales motivator say, "If you are willing to do the things that most sales reps aren't willing to do, then soon you'll be able to do and have the things that most sales reps will never be able to do and have." When I heard that statement, I was a struggling sales rep, and I was sick and tired of being sick and tired. I was at a crossroads in my career and my life, and I was either going to find a different way of making a living, or I was going to go back to school and get out of sales altogether. What I did was commit to being one of the top producers. I heard another motivator say that if the grass looks greener on the other side of the street, then you need to fertilize your lawn. He said that you don't have to change where you are in order to succeed, but rather that you can bloom where you are planted. As I mentioned before, I had many examples of that in the company where I worked. The top producers made it look easy. They never seemed to struggle. They instead seemed to intuitively know how to handle almost any sales situation. It was inspiring and intimidating at the same time. It wasn't until I finally made a commitment to be one of them that I saw how much time, discipline, and effort they put into being the best. While it did take a lot of effort for me to get there from where I was as a struggling sales rep, with commitment, determination, and daily focus, it was all worth it. Once I became a top producer, I felt like I knew the secret of what it took to live a better life, to enjoy the job and profession that just 90 days before I hated. Suddenly, I understood how easy it was. Once I was ready to do the things it took to be a top producer. And you can do it too. The good news, as I have said, is that success leaves clues. And if you are willing to invest the time, money, and effort into completely changing your results and your life, then you can. You can bloom where you are planted. And you can start enjoying the things that top producers take for granted, the things that most sales reps will never get to enjoy. You will find what I consider to be the top 10 characteristics of top sales producers. These are not only the things I do to completely change my results and reach the top, but they are also the things I see in nearly every top producer in every company that I've coached and consulted with over the past 25 years. As you listen to the list, look at the top producers at your company. You may even be one of the top reps already, and ask yourself, how many of them are doing these things? Look at your own behavior and ask yourself how many of these things you are doing and how many of them you can begin practicing right now. I guarantee that the more of these characteristics you adopt, the more successful you will be. So, if you're ready, then let's get started. Top characteristic number 1. make a commitment. Let me ask you this. Are you willing to make an intensive 90-day commitment to transforming your sales career? Would you be willing if I told you that by diligently following the proven techniques and scripts you will learn in this book, you would make a dramatic improvement in how you prospect and qualify new business, how you conduct your sales presentation, and how you deal with objections and close business? If I told you that you could move into the top 20% of the producers in your company and even double your income in just 90 days, would you be willing to make the commitment to do what is necessary? If your answer is yes, then get ready to radically change many of your habits and get ready to put in the time it's going to take to completely change the way you sell over the phone. As you will continue to hear in this section of 10 characteristics, there are many things you are going to be doing differently. But if you make the commitment now to adopting and incorporating these techniques into your selling career, then the results can and will be life-changing. But it is all going to start with making that commitment. The best way to think about this is like making a commitment to getting an A in a college course that is run on the quarter system. If any of you have attended a quarter course in college before, then you know how much is packed into each weekly lesson. I remember that on the first day of class at UCLA, the instructor went through the first 3 chapters of the textbook. By the end of the 1.5-hour class, I was already behind 3 chapters. And that was one of only 5 classes I was taking that quarter. What I had to do was seriously commit to studying, drilling, and rehearsing the material over and over again. With a lot of hard work and effort, I did ace the class, but it took a total commitment at the very beginning. The same thing will be true for you in learning a new set of skills, habits, and techniques to help you sell over the phone. In fact, one of the most difficult things you will have to do is to unlearn the way you do things now. Right now, you probably do things automatically and incorrectly. Learning a new way of responding to the objections you get over and over again will be a challenge, and you will have to practice, drill, rehearse, and record yourself relentlessly to change those old habits. But once you do, something magical happens. Once you start diligently working to change, improve, and adopt new ways of qualifying, dealing with stalls, and closing sales, your results begin to dramatically change. Suddenly, situations that used to frustrate you begin to get easier to handle, and soon you find yourself winning more and more sales. As you do, your confidence goes up, and so does your paycheck. At the end of each month, there is actually money left over, and suddenly you can begin saving for and buying the things that matter to you and your family. No more struggling because you don't have enough money. How will that feel? All of this begins affecting you differently outside of the office as well. Suddenly, you begin sleeping better, no longer worrying about money and bills. You wake up with a new energy rather than dread, and Mondays are positively transformed. Your spouse and kids begin noticing a difference, and you soon start seeing the world as a place of opportunity rather than one of closed-ended traps. Literally, your world changes. You can achieve all this if you are simply willing to make that 90-day commitment to get started. In addition to the immediate changes, though, what making the commitment also does for you is alter the future of your career. That's because once you learn proven and effective skills for selling over the phone, your results change not only for the next 90 days, but for the rest of this year and all the ones that follow. As soon as you adopt a new, successful way of selling, everything becomes easier for you. New opportunities and management open up. Your career path changes, and your confidence and enthusiasm for the profession of sales completely transforms. All of a sudden, sales becomes the greatest of professions, and your choices of what to sell and where are unlimited. And all you have to do is make a commitment today to putting in the time and effort required to get there. For everything you will gain, 90 days of intense study and practice are well worth the effort. In essence, all you are doing is developing new habits that will become your new, automatic way of doing things. I heard a saying years ago that I still repeat today. First, we form habits, and then they form us. Once you form your new, more effective selling habits, they will transform you into a top producer at your company and in your industry. Once again, I know because it happened for me. I still fondly look back on the 90 days I took to script out and memorize more effective responses. I still remember sitting in the conference room at lunchtime, listening to my recordings with a buddy, and critiquing each other's calls. I remember the determination I had as I got back on the phone that afternoon, determined not to make the same mistakes, to mute myself, and listen to what my prospect was telling me. Most of all, I remembered what that sales trainer told us the month before. If you are willing to do the things that most sales reps aren't willing to do, then you will soon be able to have and enjoy the things that most sales reps will never be able to have. Soon, I was driving a better car, buying my first house, and winning the trip to Hawaii at the end of the year. I still remember the feeling I had being picked up in a limousine, paid for by the company in Maui, and driven along the coastline to my hotel on the beach. I can't tell you how grateful I am that I was willing to make that commitment to myself. So, if you are willing to make that commitment to have a better sales career and life, then continue on, and get ready to make the changes that will have an enduring effect on everything you do from here on out. Top characteristic number 2. Be prepared for recurring selling situations. This is absolutely huge. The strange thing is that 80% of salespeople and sales teams simply don't take the time or make the effort to do it. Now that you have made the commitment, this one tip will catapult your sales and your confidence. Remember what I said earlier. One of the most important things you will ever learn about sales is that 80 to 90% of the objections, stalls, put-offs, and sales situations you run into day after day are the same. The blow-offs you got yesterday are the same ones you got last month and that you'll get next month and next year. Think about it. How many times do you hear this when you prospect or cold call? From the gatekeeper. Will he know what this call is regarding? From the prospect. I wouldn't be interested. We already have someone who handles that. Just email me something. Do any of these sound familiar? Of course they do. And I will bet you could add another 4 or 5, couldn't you? And how about the objections and stalls you get when you close a sale? How about these? We just aren't ready to make a decision yet. I'm going to have to talk to my partner, boss, spouse, committee. Your price isn't in our budget. Are these sounding familiar? Of course they are. Once again, you could easily come up with about 5 or 7 more, couldn't you? Again, here's the point. The best thing about sales, and what makes it so easy for top performers who recognize and prepare for it, is that there are only about 7 or 9 objections or stalls per selling situation, per product or service. You keep getting them over and over again. Now here's the problem. Most sales reps and companies do not leverage this important fact. Knowing what the objections and stalls are in advance is like knowing all the answers to an exam ahead of time. If you knew what the answers for a final exam were going to be, wouldn't you script out the correct answers in advance? Of course you would. Yet for some unknown reason, most sales reps don't take the time to script out and then practice, drill, and rehearse the most effective responses ahead of time. Instead, 80% of sales reps and sales teams choose to ad-lib and make up ineffective responses to these repeatable selling situations, stalls, or objections. This dooms them to fail, and is perhaps the biggest problem in the selling profession today. It makes most sales reps' lives a living nightmare, and it is why most inside sales teams fail to reach the revenue goals. Top producers, on the other hand, do leverage this sales fact to stack the odds in their favor. They take the time to develop, memorize, and then deliver effective responses to these objections, and so they easily handle and overcome them. They are not afraid of getting resistance. They are instead prepared for it. Knowing what is coming and being prepared for it enables them to listen to what their prospect is saying and allows them to question the objection and find out what is really holding a prospect back. This makes them confident and allows them to stay in the game and overcome the stalls and objections while other sales reps fold and go away. This allows top producers to preserve and close more sales. It also makes their job easy and stress-free because they know in advance what's coming and they are prepared for it. An example would be the objection, "I'm going to need to check with the boss." 80% of sales reps handle this common smokescreen objection incorrectly by saying something like, "Well, when should I call you back?" By doing it this way, they simply create a stall, and then they worry that when they finally do hear back from the prospect, the answer will be, "Well, the boss doesn't want to do it." How many times has this happened to you? A top producer, on the other hand, handles this very differently. Instead, because she has prepared for this recurring smokescreen in advance, she knows two or three proven ways to get around it. So instead of creating a stall, she uses a script that gets her prospect to reveal the true objection. She would say, "I understand, and I'm curious about something. Let's say for a moment that your boss can go either way on this and tells you to do whatever you think is best based on what we've gone over so far and what you understand about this. What would you likely do?" This is called isolating the smokescreen objection. And based on what the prospect then says, the top producer will have the information she needs to make the next effective step. Hint: any answer other than "I would do it" means that talking to the so-called boss is a smokescreen and not the real objection. If this is the case, then the producer has more work to do to uncover what is really holding this prospect back. And guess how she is going to do that? By using additional scripts that she has prepared in advance. This is what I mean by knowing what is coming in advance and then being able to leverage that knowledge and effectively and competently handle it. And that is your assignment for this week. Start by making a list of all the stalls, put-offs, and objections you get with your sale during the prospecting call, the presentation, and all the follow-up calls. Then, commit to adapting and customizing the many scripts you'll hear in this book so they are just right to handle them. Then, once you've found the ones that work, I recommend you script out 3 or 4 responses for each objection. Spend the time to practice, drill, and rehearse those best practice responses until you can deliver each one automatically. If you are willing to do this, again, what 80% of your competition won't take the time and effort to do, then soon you will enjoy closing more sales, making more money, and living a more confident and successful life as a sales professional. Top characteristic number 3. Record and critique your calls for 90 days. A top inside sales trainer, Stan Ballou, first introduced me to this concept. He said that nothing would help you double your income in 90 days faster than recording and critiquing your calls each day. He also said that most sales reps would not be willing to do this, and he's right. But, he said, if you are willing to do it, then you can quickly move into the top 20% of the selling professionals in your company and industry. He was right there, too. If you have any resistance to this idea, then just remember that all professionals record their performances and use them to improve how they practice and perform. Think about how much time football players spend watching game film, or dancers spend watching film of their practices and performances, or actors and directors spend watching a previous day's shoot. Every professional records, critiques, and gets better by analyzing and improving their technique, their strategies, and their performance by recording and breaking down each part of their performance. You need to as well. Once I made a commitment to recording and carefully critiquing my calls, I was amazed by how much I found. You will be too. Here are some things to be on the lookout for when playing your calls back. 1. How well did you listen to your prospect or client? This is huge, because once you begin hearing yourself on a sales call, you'll be amazed by how much and how quickly you start talking. In fact, you will be stunned by how quickly you start talking over your prospect. 2. Did you hear what your prospect or client was truly saying? Or did you just hear what you wanted to hear? Clients and prospects are always trying to tell us what's important to them, but most of the time, we don't hear it. When you begin listening to your calls, you will see the need to begin using your mute button so you can begin hearing the buying signals and potential objections. 3. Did you ask all the right qualifying questions? A fundamental problem in sales is that most prospects don't close because they were.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.